to thank the organizer of this 7th International Congress on Human Science for having, for inviting me to present this paper. I would specially thank Professor Dr. Karim Jacob Martin and the University Abbot of Ilia, CEU Barcelona, for giving me this opportunity to be a part of this conference. To begin with, I have titled my paper as Role of the Caste System in Dharmashastra and Analysis. That is the burning questions till now in India. This paper is based on sacred Sanskrit texts, especially Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, and Athar Veda. Further, this paper has been corroborated with the help of other texts like Dharmasutra and Samritis, which is called Dharmashastra also. We are aware with the fact that Sanskrit text, including the knowledge of spirituality, philosophy, devotion, ritual, and literature. We are also aware that these texts, including the scientific knowledge, the scientists such as Aryabhatta, Varahamihira, Bhaskar, Charak, Sushrut, and mathematician have produced a vast ocean of the knowledge. In spite of such a vast tradition of the scientific thinking, it is questioned to be considered as why there is a lack of scientific reflection on the question of the caste in India specifically. The caste has been a problem since the origin of the society and has acquired the natural space in modern society too. Therefore, it is fitness of things that they need to be debated today. In this context, I want to raise few questions regarding the caste in Dharmashastra. The concept of Dharma is based on the idea that the universe is governed by a certain natural law and moral law guiding the people lives should be consciousness with natural law. Right from the ancient era in India, there was a push to empower the upper class politically as well as socially. It was only in 19th century that voice of the elite could be heard. Even today, the psychic structure has remained dominated. Ghettoization of the lower caste has not reduced even today. The source of this mental structure is in the ancient society, which passed through a procedure codification in the era of Dharmashastra before taking concrete shape in the present scenario. In the stratification form of the Varna order, position of Sudras has been of subordinate who have been neglected, deprived, and destined to be ruled over at every level of the life. Since all this was planned through Dharmashastra in the Sanskrit language, the Shudra also got self-induced to knowledge their slavery and accept it as a divinely ordained destiny. In the religious scripture, Samritis are treated like law books. Hence, they have also regarded as a medium for understanding the contemporary social order. Subordinate condition of the Shudras can be understood from the Vedic verses related to origin of the Varna system. The fundamental mantras of Varna Vavastha is as follow. Brahmanasya Mukham Asir Bahu Rajinya Krita Madhyam Tadashya Yad Varshya Padbhyam Shudro Ajayat. And Atharveda is also written mantra Brahmanasya Mukham Asir Bahu Rajinya Krita Madhyam Tadashya Yad Varshya Padbhyam Shudro Ajayat. You can see the slide of these mantras in Sanskrit text, holy Sanskrit text we can say. Brahman is the mouth of Brahma, Akshatriya is the arm, Vaishya originated from thighs, and Shudra born from the feet of Brahma. We will discuss this in the more detail later in this paper. Now I would like to discuss the Varna and its relation with the caste system. The word Varna is derived from the Sanskrit word vari, which means adopting or choosing a particular type of the profession. Etymologists have unanimously agreed on that meaning of word Varna is to adopt or choose. Maharishi Dayanand in the preface of Rig Veda, the Bhashya explained that Varna means worthy of adoption or choice, or which have been adopted or chosen on the basis of the action and deeds of an individual, which determine his or her Varna. There are several different meanings attached to the word Varna in expert dictionary as verb, color, describe, etc. As a noun, the luster, color, race, species, breed, type, one letter sound, one word sound like prestige, a garment, etc. In the Dharmashastra, the word Varna has been used for Chaturvarna, for fold caste system. Some scholars believe that word Varna and the caste are synonyms to each other. But in the ancient India, there are four Varna as well as a few caste. From the Vedic times to epic age, the status of Shudras kept on changing to assimilate them into the ever-increasing caste system. It is clearly shows that situation of Shudras was identical, but we know that ancient India was a patriarchal society. Apastam Dharma Sutra talks about the duty and social behavior that one must maintain according to the one's Varna caste order. Brahmin should greet the people with the right arm separate and teaching the ears. A Kshatriya should greet while spreading arms parallel to his chest, while Vaishya spreading arms parallel to abdomen, and Shudra get greet spreading arm downward parallel to the edge. Except for Shudra al preceding Varna should pronounce the last letter with long down tone of their greeting and reply to the same in the answer. Many such rules found their way in such religious texts and samritis, which gives us help deep insight of our unstructured daily routine. The sexual relation of the woman for three upper castes with Shudra is the cause of profanity. There is no atonement of such adultery. Shudra man had to suffer a lot in such scenario. Laws and punishment were always paradoxical as well as the anomalous of the Shudras. The Shudra should not perform participate in any offering or festival attributed to the alignment of, for example, Vrat, Tap and Home. The marriage between the upper caste man and the Shudra was not either legitimate to. The Brahmin women were forbidden to talk or look directly to any Shudra. Even the shadow of Shudra could sully preciousness of the Brahmin. The child born of the union of the Brahmin woman and Shudra man was Chandal, a word attribute to an occultist who was rarely allowed to come out of the forest and step their foot on mainland. These regulations of the social system have been established to be consistent with the religion, to which religious penal laws are also attributed. Only through them, inviolability of Varnashram Dharma caste system, you can say, has been ensured. These regulations have been strictly implemented not only for Shudras but also on the Brahman. The natural acceptance of its low position in social stratification is simply a process of hegemony. Dr. Suvira Jaiswal had quoted, often the lower caste follow the rules of the caste more enthusiastically rather than upper caste. The duty of kind is to make sure that Vaishya and Shudras should perform these tasks in accordance to their Varna. Otherwise, it could create a mislegitimate for the universal order. The moment Shudra stops serving all the upper three Varna, that scenario would be the harbinger of the era of Kali Yuga. You can say Kali Yuga, Treta Dwapar and Sati Yuga. I am mentioning here Kali Yuga, a time attributed to the settling of the old social and economic structure. If entire world, politics and history can be reduced to one word, that word is power. The 1% of the total population rules the rest. Michael Foucault was right when he proclaimed that means of the discipline exudes the power, thus created a disciplined society. Brahman want a stagnant society so that there would not be the duck of their Brahmin Akshatriya's rules, etc. Perhaps fear of God could help them to delay the end of their rule, their power and their politics and their law. Now we are coming to the point of gradation, hegemonization and confederation of the caste system in the society. Though the Brahman did not have any major role in the origin of the Varna order, however, they not only managed to project their origin as divine, but also got the large number of the audience who could acknowledge their Dharmashastra. They enacted the provision of edible, inedible, pure, impure, touchable, untouchable for the people. In addition, they created a new group into the society known as untouchable, which were beyond the pale of the Varna caste-based system. I have mentioned the last slide. If you can say, Brahman, Akshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. And lastly, I mentioned the untouchable, whose Varna is not included there, where it is, you can say, untouchable outcast of the caste. Now coming to the point, in various Shastra texts, the theory was given in terms of the food, which further strengthened the caste system in the long term. It is reverse. The Manusmriti has given some method arrangements for accepting food from the Shudras, agriculturalist, family, friends, and Das and Gopal, cowherder. Food prepared by the barber could be accepted. There are certain provisions under which the food cooked by Shudras could be accepted. Two, Shudras dealing fairly should tonsure every month, and for them the method of purification is like Vaishya. That is, Shudras should eat only the leftover the food of the twice born. Om Prakash Valmiki, a Dalit writer in present scenario. Lastly, I have discussed the ancient period of the Dharma Shastra, which we can find in Sanskrit text and specifically in India, reference of India. If the Shudra is also contingent on religion at the time of contingency and emergency, his food is accepted for eating. In this way, the Shudra born was also got divided into two categories. As follow, untouchable Shudra, which could be touched, that is whose food Brahman could not accept. Secondly, the touchable Shudra, which could be touched, that is whose food Brahman could accept. The emergency of untouchability is also the result of the system which has remained for centuries. Outside the Varna order, there was another group which was called Kaukast. I have already discussed. He was not in the category of even Shudras and was outside the margin of the society. That group was Chandal, upon from strict restriction on this routine personal contact and roti beti. You can say food and marriage. Tough penance of the fire and food for having sexual intercourse with the Chandal woman if he do. The Brahman would unknowingly go to the Chandal caste. He eats the food given by the Chandal. This is the fallen from the status, and he is deliberately goes if he becomes akin to Chandal. His specific behavior, dealing although with purity, provision for accepting the food from Shudra had been made. The correct examination of the caste code indoors of the practicing, classification of the caste and concept of purity, impurity. If the Shudra is a guest, take some work from him and give him food. Maharishi Manu believes that dry food brought from the Shudra's house becomes a sacred in the house of Vipra. Vipra, that is called Brahman, upper caste, hierarchy system in the upper caste. When cooked with cow milk, curd, etc., the food brought by the impure Shudra is inedible, whether it is touched or not touched. While eating the food, if the Shudra touches the food of Vipra, then it should not be eaten. Do not eat food with people who have no elite yoga. Divide of educational good manners, accept Shudra's food present of all the caste in worth eating, so eat their cooked after touching it gold or fire, while arousing the deliciousness of the food. The moment you have respect to profession, you should stop consuming the food cooked by the Shudras. Do not consume food cooked by a person who earns his living by picture making, painting, black color, etc. If the Shudras have prepared without inception or supervision of an Aryan, the householder should go and kept that food on fire, sprinkling water on it. In this way, the food is also said to be worth offering to the deity. Apastam Dharma Sutra makes a strange provision while strengthening the purity impurity concept. If you give your residual food to a non-Brahman, then scrap your teeth and put it small into the food. According to Mara Dharma Sangraha, there is no option to give the woman and Shudra into the sacrifice. This is as a soch penance of 3 years old, soch and soch. I am speaking on the soch and a soch, purity and impurity of the concept. There will be one day a soch if a girl dies or after 3 years of the vagdan engagement. I am speaking all these things. Their purification period also differ from the Varna to Varna. Brahman in 10 days, Akshatriya in 12 days, Vasya in 15 days. And Shudra, the most important thing, that is the research area of mine. Shudra is purified in a month after the death of Sampita aesthetic. Brahmin should not follow the after the death of Shudra or Sampita. He followed with the affection. Then by touching the butter and fire and eating the clarified buttermilk, a Brahmin purified. For earning in income, dead body was taken by the Shudra is enjoyed to undergo the ashoch of 12 nights or half month or number of the season. If a Brahmin of low knowledge follows the body of the dead Shudras, then he remains in ashoch for 3 years. By eating the food of Shudras, by Dvij people, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, they should undergo the Chandrika Krich fast for their purification. I am also speaking all these things. Last important thing is that Shudra, who conduct himself according to Shastras, should transfer his head every month. The method of purification of Shudra is that of the Vaishya. A Shudra is ordained to eat leftover the residual food left by the Dvij. It is self-evident from the above principle of Soch Asoch, pure impure, that Shudra is an indefinitely impure caste varna itself, which cannot be upward its position in the stratified system. Instead, in order to maintain its impure fourth position, he has to make it possible by only going through a purification process. Whether it is food-related regulation or process of purity, impurity, in the historical process, it evolves into untouchability-based caste system. In the era of Dharmasutra and Samriti, touchability and untouchability began to be made the part of human social psychology. The status of apastham dharmasutra is the apparent touch of the water if you happen to touch the chanda. Speak to the Brahman after speaking to the Shudra. If you happen to look at him, make the atonement by looking at the rays of the sun, etc. Now coming to the point of judicial system. What is the position of the Shudras in the judicial system in Dharmashastra? The studies of canon of Dharmashastra make it clear that by the time of writing of Dharmashastra and Samriti, gradually caste-based social system had almost effected the boycott of Shudras by the upper three caste and complete domination over him by them. It is also confirmed by the duty of judicial procedure and process. The penal laws for the Shudras were extremely strict, though at least at one level in the judicial process, he could be a part of witness. The provision of Shudra's participation as a witness can be seen in the penal laws, household, father of the son, residence of a while, akshatriya, vaishya, and shudra. These people become witness of a plaintiff. Nobody who ever can be a witness, money matters except in contingency. The last words of the woman in last words, twice born, upper caste. I am skipping all these things. In the social system, these regulations establish penal law which are effective in the event of the weakening of the fear of paralog, other world. On being infiltrated with the low caste woman, marriage of Dvij with them soon results in their being converted into the Shudra along with their children and family. It is certain that downward movements of the Varna must have been normal and recurring events which are favorable of the Brahman system. The plenty laws are not only effective measures in the social system, but it is more favorable to get consent of those who live within the system. Within this Brahman system, religious is based on these conventions in which elog, prolog and other arrangements have been formed, peace did. Conclusion of my paper, whatever you heard, today is not the story of African slave who were aligned from their home land for the owners. Brutal production of the cash crops in the American continents, but the real tale of woe of the ghettoization and servitude of every born people of the same motherland in India. It is the story of the dishonor by every same people. It is the story that how Almighty used it as a tool, how his fear was quartered over the mind of the millions for the thousand of the years of the greed and power of the few. Harass punishment which Shudras faced was paradoxical. It appears that they were second-rate citizens in the society with wide exemption in the prescribed punishment. In penal laws for crime committed against Shudras, it is also proved that even their second-grade existence was not tolerable and was open to an exemption for the atrocities against them. The miserable and uncertain economic condition of the inferior caste is revealed by the statement that to take the birth of the Chanda Nishad Vyan, Ratnakar, Puskar to lead a life of a vagrant full of all these stories. Poverty, even lack of the food, clothing, and in the situation of the Chandal woman, wrapped in the rags with a begging bowl in the hand, is posed a wonder around the state her anger. Thus, it can be seen in the flexible caste system started in the Vedic time, had generated rigid ethnic rights within itself by the time of writing of Dharmashastra and Samhitas. The society had been completely graded on basis of purity, impurity, Shudras, while being the part of the village system, often lived a life of the second-rate citizen or slave. At the center of all this process was religion, and Shudra's concept was also obtained for this suspended role in the social order. In this way, the gradual development of the caste system and its exclusion in the society can be seen at different intervals of the time in the religious scripture. Thank you so much to all of you for having a present. Thank you.
Okay.
Jai.
Now, I think it's a